Now guys, this video hasn't been uploaded on YouTube like ever. I was the first one to modify the single phase rectifier into three phase with the help of single diodes, and then this is another of the first one by coupling two rectifiers together to create one single powerful three phase bridge rectifier. Hi guys, you're watching channel Mr. Electron, and this what you see is a three phase rectifier which I made from a single phase rectifier and a few single diodes, and its capability is around 18 amperes. I uploaded its video a few weeks back. So today in this video I'm going to make a 35 amperes three phase rectifier using two single phase bridge rectifiers with a maximum surge capability of up to 400 amperes. So guys, the first step is to keep the rectifiers together such that the text part is towards you. After that, take some metal piece with holes in it such that the hole distance for the two rectifiers matches the hole distance of the plate. Okay, then take some screws. Okay, and the next step is easy. Okay, remove one rectifier, place the bolt in the hole and bring it through the rectifier hole and just place the nut. Same for the other one. Now guys, comes the soldering, or you can see the connection part. You can see some kind of oil on the rectifier black part. That is WD-40 that I have placed on the terminals to remove any possible rust that prevents us from better soldering. Well, I'm actually trying it. I'm not sure how it is going to turn out. Well guys, adding WD-40 was a terrible idea, although it didn't cause any trouble, but still it didn't work as expected. But this did, my Dremel tool. Okay, so let's clean the oxidation on the terminals. Well, try and use the Dremel and it will do wonders for you. You see how clean the terminal is when compared to the other one. You can see the oxidation on this one and how clean this piece is. Well guys, the removal of oxidation layer is complete now. It's time to do some soldering. Let's see how it performs now. You see how beautiful the soldering is working now, all because of the removal of oxidation layer. Okay, so comes the positive. Done. After soldering this wire, measure the length from here to here because we are going to connect the positive terminal of this rectifier with the positive terminal of this rectifier. Okay, yeah, this much. So let's take it here. Yeah, if you use a thicker wire, it cuts a few strands sometimes. So guys, after completing the soldering for the red positive of the rectifiers, which came out really good, even better than I expected, comes the negative connection, which will be denoted by the black wire as always. Okay, now guys, since this part of the diode is positive, so its diagonal opposite, which is this one, is going to be the negative. So I'm going to solder the black wire on this negative terminal of the rectifier. And that's done. After that, the same thing for this one. Measure the distance of the black wire from here to the diagonal opposite of this positive, which is this one. Again, the negative. So I'm taking it up to here. Done. Now comes the stripping part, wire stripping. Yeah, still, it's coming like this, which is not bad. Now guys, the rest comes easy and the soldering part is over. Three input cables for three phase and two output for DC. So I'm choosing these two high current wires for the DC output, which will be our common output positive and negative. This red piece, you see this red terminal positive, okay, red wire will be connected denoting the final positive, and this one, you see the diagonal opposite, denotes the final output negative. And note that the links for the components used in this video for making this project will be provided in the description. If you want to buy them, you can check the links out in the description. Yeah, this is good. Same for this one. See, really strong. Done. So final output cables are done, positive and negative. Red positive, black negative, and also the output from positive and negative of this rectifier connected to this one with jumper cables. Now comes the AC input cables that are to be connected. So guys, these are the wires that I'm going to use for the three phase connection. So for the first rectifier, which is this one on which these red and black cables are connected, the two terminals are open. Okay, you see this one is open and this one is also open. So simply connect two wires or connector cables on these. So that's for single phase. Now for the third phase, you see this one is also AC and this one is also AC. Choose any of the two and simply connect this cable and you have the three phase input. So guys, our three phase rectifier is ready for testing. Now guys, you have already seen my wind turbine generator, high current brushless three phase output. Okay, so let's connect it to the rectifier. And guys, this is my 55 watts car headlamp bulb, which I usually use for testing alternators, motors and generators. Connected. Let's see. Yeah. You see it is glowing just by hand rotation. So the rectifier is working really nice. Let's do rope rotation. Well guys, I think that the rope was not long enough and also it was really difficult to pull the thread from that angle. So I've changed the camera angle and increased the length of the rope because the diameter of the pulley is really big. Okay, keep watching. Oh, the bulb over here. Go. Yeah, now it's working really nice. So let's turn off the lights and do it once again. Now only the camera lights are on, rest is all turned off. Trying it the second time. Okay. Oh.
Thought bulb might have fused.
Let's make sure that it is not fused. Yeah, it is working. It was really bright this time. So our rectifier is working really good. It can handle huge currents now with a max of up to 400 amperes and continuous current of 35 amperes. And you can also use the 50 amperes diode. This is a 35 amps. 50 amps is just identical, a little bigger but just the same, and can carry more current. Yeah. So guys, anyways, thanks for watching this video. Hit like and subscribe and see you in the next one. Bye.